So, I am having, it's Friday night, I'm having like, I'm trying to give myself like the lowest key Friday I can have. Trying to cut everything out. I work for myself, usually from home. And because of that, I always feel like I should be working, like I should always be doing something. And, I really need to work, make an effort to give myself a break from work. So, not really because it's like the beginning of the year, but it just kind of coincidentally happened that I started realizing that I wasn't, in the moment. There's those things like Eckhart Tolle and these things of, like be in the now and stuff. I've been really trying to practice that, not just kind of know about it. And everything, trying to reduce stress, and 'cause I just really let myself get like so amped up sometimes. And just work and work and work, and I think probably it's unproductive the more I'm working, without giving myself a break. So to try to even extend this effort of, being more in the moment and not worrying so much about work and all that, I'm taking today and or this evening. I worked all day. I'm just like, I thought, oh, how can I have like the most relaxing day? And so I came across an article. It was like an Oprah article or something like that. And it said like, oh, 6 ways to reduce stress. And one of them, I think the first one, it was get like a coloring book for adults. I was like, well, that's kind of cool. Actually, I haven't done it for a long time, but I would like take swirls and then I would draw like with a pen, always like a ballpoint pen kind of thing. And I would draw in, I just kind of like do little swirls around. And so it would make like little bulbs, almost like Christmas lights, like on a strand, just kind of around. And I would draw in those bulbs, and man, it would like totally bring my breathing down like to a real steady, even slow breath. And it was like the fastest way for me to get like work and stress off of my shoulders. But I haven't done that for a while. But anyway, when I saw that coloring book thing, I was like, I should do that. So I went to the store and I got a coloring book. They did not have an adult coloring book. I'm guessing you can only buy those online. So I got a dinosaur one instead. So I got dinosaurs and crayons. So that'll be fun. Anyway, then I don't know, was I scrolling through Facebook or something, and I saw like sugar cookies with the that you use a stamp for, or like a stencil or whatever, a cookie cutter, I guess that's what they're called. So I was like, I should do that, because I realized another thing that I don't do for myself is things that I would do, if I was hanging out with friends or going to a party. I would make things like, well, I have never actually made cookies with a cookie cutter that I can recollect, probably when I was little. But I wouldn't do those kind of things for myself. I would only do it like to share with other people, or to give away. And I thought, I need to do that for myself. And so I also bought cookie cutters, and I was hoping I could indulge a little more in my childhood fantasies and get like animal shapes, but this was literally the last of the cookie cutters at the store, and I didn't feel like running around. After all, this is my evening to like be a kid, so I didn't want to run around. So anyway, I got stars and hearts, and I'm gonna skip the circles because that's a little too boring for my creative likes. And then I got, this is my adulting of the evening. It's supposed to be my kidding evening, but this is my adulting. I have never had a rolling pin, so I got myself a rolling pin. And surprisingly, it was less than $4. I didn't know they were, like, so cheap. So now I have a rolling pin to roll out my cookies. And while those are chilling in the refrigerator, I've got my coloring. And I am even going to turn off my internet, have no Wi-Fi running. That's another thing I kind of want to do is, you know, maybe just unplug my modem more often. So, and to include, like, I don't know, feel out more of, you know, what it was like when I was little. Because do you feel that when you were little, afternoons or evenings would be like forever, you know? And now evenings are like done like that, you know? A few hours long, you're into bed, and then the next morning starts. So, you know, trying to think of that mindset I had when I was a kid. You know, I didn't focus on anything outside of now. And so anyway, so I'm doing that as well. And to complement that, I'm wearing my pajama shirt, or one of my pajama shirts. I'm wearing one of my favorite loose, comfy sweaters and skirt, and it doesn't go together. And I've got like fuzzy socks on. And anyway, I'm just going to enjoy and try to like have the slowest, most inward or momentarily focused evening. No thoughts outside, just now. And I'm going to try to, you know, feel that mindset, you know, that so many kids have, like, where a year is literally a lifetime and an evening is like a week long, you know. So anyway, getting started, I'm first going to turn off the internet. Oh, and, let's see, this is really far down. And, in trying to keep with the pampering myself, right? Whereas, things that I would do for other people, but never for myself. So to try to do that today, I made for dinner, I had deviled eggs. Let's see, I have three halves remaining, so... Yeah, I deviled eggs. Oh, and I also grilled up some red peppers. Anyway, you know, I just really wanted to do what I would never do for myself. And I even put, like, sprinkled on the paprika. You know, if I would have made this effort before for myself, like, so much effort, I wouldn't have sprinkled on the paprika because you can't really taste the paprika. It's just for looks. But I was like, I'm going to do that. So... I've even got the paprika on my deviled eggs. Anyway, I have, and I'm trying not to touch my phone. I have my recipe written out on an envelope, and I'm going to start on the cookies. Oh, and in case you are interested in seeing those like little swirls or whatever, I highly recommend it. This is one that, I keep them in my drawer next to my bed, and I've got this is like the most recent one. See, I just like draw like circles, like little swirls, you know, like do 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 do, and then like go over to the next one and all that sort of stuff. And then I just draw them in, I draw in the parts that kind of overlap and make, you know, make little shapes. Like there, I might draw that one in. So. And I guess most recently I've been working on like this bigger one. So it's really good for, you know, if you really have to, if like you just seriously need to cool down right away, I highly recommend drawing those little circles. I haven't done it for a while, but maybe I should start. Now I got my, dinosaur coloring book. So we'll see how that goes tonight. The cool thing about having a pilot light underneath your stovetop? Is your stove always just a teeny bit warm? And it's kind of perfect for like softening butter, you know, because most recipes, they require butter, at least like baked goods or whatever. They always want softened butter or room temperature. And I'm not regularly predetermining that I'm going to make cookies or something that requires that. So it's kind of nice to have, I can just let the butter sit out there for less time than it would require if it was just going to be softened by the room temperature. So, all right, do I need butter? 1 cup sugar. In the RV, I always keep things in glass jars. Of course, I guess it's probably a good idea no matter what, but I like it because it's rodent proof, you know, bug proof, moths. Yeah, my parents, they'll it's like every time I go back to my mom's house or my parents' house, you know, like if I make something, like I get out flour and there's like moths in it. I don't know why they get a lot of moths, but yeah, so I guess it doesn't have to be like an RV thing, but it's kind of nice to keep everything in glass jars. I've had, so actually I started coloring already. It's actually pretty fun. I mean, it's like I totally get absorbed into it. So I'm enjoying that. I've had no sound, no video streamed over the internet, no Pandora, no music, no YouTube, nothing. So it's just been really quiet. And pretty different than normal because, you know, I got something going on. But it's kind of nice to, like, really shut out the world. Except you guys, I guess. I guess you're not shut out. However, in this very moment, it's just me and Andiamo. So, it's pretty relaxing. And you're not making any noise that I can hear. So, all right, sugar with the butter. I'm just using a, what is it, like All Recipe or like Food Network. I'm just using like a, like some random recipe from the internet. Alright, I don't have an electric mixer, so I'm going to mix it with a fork. Where's that measuring cup? So this whole process is taking like forever. You know, waiting for the butter to soften, and then my mom called and I got in a conversation with her, and then was texting my aunt. So I'm getting out of my child playtime, and I'm like still in the middle of the cookies. I kind of think I'm probably not gonna get to be rolling them out tonight, Yeah, we'll see. Moving along. I'm not going to worry about it. I think my egg is next. One beaten egg. When I was little, my mom actually, she would make wedding cakes for money. She, like, every, you know, every few weeks or so. Actually, I don't know how frequently, I was so little. But she always had, like, you know, cakes to deliver or, you know, like a wedding cake. And we'd, like, carry it there or, you know, some birthday cake to, like, a school or, what's up? So, yeah, I remember she would often make an icing that was made by, like, whipping the eggs. So, what? What, is there something under there? My dog is the biggest baby. Yeah, you're a baby. I don't know what he's whining about. He'll, like, make crazy noises because, like, a preferred piece of food went under the table and he couldn't get it, or like it went hiding under like a bent piece of paper or something. What?
It's there. I don't know what's there. What is it, big? What? I don't know. Here, give me that.
So anyway, yeah, every time I think about, like, I think that's called a, I don't know if that's called, like, meringue, where you beat the eggs to, like, that sort of consistency, but she'd beat them up, you know, and they would, like, become super puffy, and that was my least favorite kind of icing she would make. I never really liked it, but I think she did it often because it was kind of easy. But I'd always stand there, you know, and I'd get, like, little scraps and, like, dip it in the icing. And all right, a tablespoon of milk. What? What?
What is it? What, Beaky?
He's so funny too, like, if something moves, because he's really afraid of, like, things that fall, or, you know, if they, like, tilt, he's really afraid of them. So sometimes his dog dish will, like, move a little bit, or, like, cause something to move, and then he'll freak out. So I think that's what's going on. All right. Now I just need, oops, I think I got this on my sweater. Maybe not. Here we go. All right, It's almost 9 o'clock. I think when I started this, or when I had the idea, it was like 5:30 or, you know, almost 6. So, this has been like a long process. But it's been a pretty relaxing evening, and that was the goal anyway. So, this has to chill for 2 hours. But I think I read somewhere it's better if it chills longer. So, I'm going to let it chill overnight. And hopefully I actually get around to like rolling it out and, you know, cutting the cookies and not just eating the dough raw. Which is pretty good. So, yeah, good. Who doesn't like cookie dough? Alright. I think when I get this put away, I'm gonna indulge myself in my dinosaur coloring book again. Well, those cookies, I kept them as, you know, you can keep the dough and refrigerate it for a while. And in fact, they say that's better. So I refrigerated it, refrigerate it overnight, but I kept those cookies in the refrigerator for like days. And I finally got around to it, and then I like ate them up, you know, in like less than 24 hours. So all that work, and I even had to buy like a rolling pin and what else? Rolling pin. Oh yeah, of course I bought the little shapes and stuff. But the days that it was in the refrigerator, I was actually eating the dough just raw. So anyway, I had a few cookies left over, and I gobbled them up. So yeah, I don't know when I'm going to do that next, but anyway, I'm in the middle of a little project right now, and I'm so excited. I'm always excited to get out my sewing machine. And people wonder, they're like, where do you got a sewing machine in your RV? And it's actually under the bed. That's kind of my throw-all for big items, you know, that I don't know what to do with. Like, my guitar case is in there. This crazy old printer that I've had since, like, the year 2000. It's like this big, and I'm sure I could find an even better printer now for, you know, something like this, but I don't print that much, and we'll see. Who knows? I'll keep the printer for now. It's okay, but at some point I need to get rid of it. It doesn't even print that well. It's there's always like a kind of a dark bar on the side, so it's a little bit of a piece of junk that I'm carrying around. But in the meantime, it's useful when I need it, and I don't actually need the space where it's at right now anyway. So yeah, I go under my bed to get it. I used to keep my vacuum under there, but it was so inconvenient to go in and out of there, you know, and I have to make sure I have on a shirt that is like cotton or something, because it's wood underneath, and I have to like let it rest on my back, and it can like, you know, maybe like splinter different shirts or whatever. Anyway, it's a huge inconvenience to get underneath my bed. So I moved my vacuum. Now I've got it underneath the sink. And I had a bunch of shoes on the bottom shelf under the sink, and I put those under the bed. I'm not using them regularly, I guess. And the vacuum underneath here. And actually, it's a vacuum that, like, you know, there's the kind, so there's like the regular kind that you push, and then some of them, they have a thing where you can like actually take out the middle part of the vacuum, so you can't push it anymore, but you can hold it and then vacuum. So actually, I got rid of the part that it would sit in to be able to like push it, you know? So now it's like this big, and it's kind of the most convenient size for an RV. So it's like a great vacuum, but much smaller. So it fits underneath my sink now. It's still a little inconvenient to get out, just because of, I don't know. It'd be inconvenient everywhere unless it was like already set up, you know, like sitting out there. So it's in a pretty good spot. Anyway, what I'm working on, I've got my mint tea here.
So I have this blanket. I actually got it from my grandma. I think when she moved into a... Well, she moved into, like, some sort of retirement home or something. And, or from one to another, and then didn't have a spare bedroom or something. So I got this blanket from her. And I love it. It's just somehow it feels like really, like, I don't know, spring air or summer air or something. Anyway, the outside's really great. But then the underside, it's this terrible material. And when I touch it with my hands, I don't totally feel it. But when my foot touches this or my leg touches this at night, you know, and there's no sheet, like the sheet got moved or something, it makes me so cranky. I can't stand this material. And my heel, like I don't have like the smoothest heels, I guess. I mean, they're not that bad, but you know, you get like little dry skin pieces and it like sticks to this material and it just drives me nuts. So I can only really use this blanket if I've definitely got enough like sheets or something else below it. But then it like falls off or whatever. Anyway, it's kind of the perfect thickness to use during the summer. This plus a sheet. Well, this is my sheet. Well, this sheet is, it also doesn't stay in place. And so anyway, I'm trying to, I thought, you know what, if I could just freaking sew these things together, I would never have to feel this horrible material. And even the convenience of this too is this sheet, it's kind of like that microfiber or something, so it's like super soft. Well, actually only one side is really soft and the other side gets like these little balls in it. So I'm sewing the crappy side of the sheet to the crappy side of the blanket. And it'll just kind of be like a new combined blanket. So it's like a fun project. I get to use my sewing machine. It doesn't have to be perfect. I don't need seams to be straight. So I'm just really excited about doing this. This was actually my grandmother's sewing machine, the same grandma as this blanket was. Just checking. Sometimes I'll run out of thread on the bobbin. Yeah, so her name, it's actually sketched down under here into the metal of the sewing machine. So that's kind of neat. Historical. Ironic in a way, I guess, because it's her blanket and her sewing machine. Yeah, so at some point I should probably do a how to use a sewing machine. It's actually pretty easy, but there are a lot of kind of interesting components, you know? There's a top thread, and then there's a thread that's comes up from the bottom. And then the needle, as it goes through, it, like, pulls the thread up, you know, and pushes the top thread down. So it it sews it. You know, it's kind of like staples it. I mean, it just kind of, one from the top and one from the bottom so that it comes together. And you always want to have, like, whatever you're sewing, the fabric super flat right here. You know, it can go behind and, like, this stuff, but it has to be really flat right here. And the needles, I'm always breaking needles. You can't be, like, pulling on the fabric or the needle will break. mom taught me to sew when I was like, geez, like 4 or 5, something like super young. And I made my first stuffed animal when I was like, I don't know, 4 or 5. And it was a square green animal, I guess. It had like a square head, and then it had a square body, and it had square arms, and I can't remember if it had ears or not. And unfortunately, I did not have the foresight to keep it. Actually, it might still be like in storage, I don't know, underneath my parents' house or something. But it was like this little green thing, and I think for the arms I used like a pink material or something, so I never really was like, oh, I love this stuffed animal, but it would be kind of cool to see it. And then my mom taught me how to do the circles, but I really just wanted to start, you know, really simple, so I did squares. So that green stuffed animal. I was always a big stuffed animal fanatic. I never liked dolls. I had no interest in, like, playing with anything human-like. I always liked the animals, you know, this fuzzy and cute and... So, and I still prefer animals to humans. So interesting how that happens. I had one doll that I don't know, I think like an aunt of a girlfriend of an uncle or something got me. Somebody that didn't really know me. Well, I don't know who got it for me. But her name was Jem. She was a rock star, and her whole body was metallic pinky purple. And she was enormous. She was like way bigger than a Barbie. And her feet were like flat, and she was just really big. She seemed like some big robot, and I had no idea how anybody could be interested in playing with something like that. I always liked the animals, and he even, whenever I played with, like, animals and stuff, or like, My Little Ponies or something, you know, and I'd be, like, pretending that they're going on a journey, I never, you know, they came with, like, hairbrushes and, like, furniture and, like, little things like that, and I always... The journeys that I remember making my toys go on, they had nothing. It was like as light as possible, you know, so they could like further or go longer. They didn't have to, you know, carry as much. And I'm still like that too. Like I'm a lightweight traveler. I'm living in an RV. I like to not be connected. And so it's kind of interesting. And then there's another habit now that I'm thinking of it, that I noticed from when I was little. My grandma, she every time she came over, she'd bring me like this one, I don't know, these like sets or whatever, but there was sets of these dolls, and she'd bring me one each. Okay, they were human. However, I liked them. I never played with them, but I liked them because they were like representing traditional clothing. And even traditional skin color, you know, it wasn't all like white babies or something, you know, and like styles of hair of different cultures. And I thought that was so cool. I remember I had like 5, and I was so excited to see when she'd come over, because I couldn't wait to see the clothing of like a new country. And I just thought that was so cool. And I still love cultures. I love cultures and languages and traditions and like foods and stuff. So I'm so interested in that stuff. And I don't know if that triggered it, those little dolls that she'd bring over when I was little, or if it's just kind of something innate that we're born with. That's my history of doll playing when I was little, continuing with the inner child theme of this video. school. I'm almost to the end. So the sewing machine has, like, underneath, okay, so you have the needle, and then you have the bottom of the sewing machine, and then the fabric comes in here. Well, here at the base, there's, like, two little feet, and they're kind of rough, so they can kind of catch on to the fabric, and they move, so that's how the fabric is kind of going through on its own. The feet are moving it, so I'm not pushing it or pulling it. It's the part of the sewing machine that helps do that. My better blanket has started. Yeah, here I got a little bit far away from the white. Should have had it up a little bit, but I think it'll be okay. Nice! So I'm not just going to do like a square around, because then it'd be like a big kind of puffy balloon in the middle. But I'll do like a square around. And then I'll do like a couple bits here and there. Just like on a quilt, you know, it's not like you don't have the back that just balloons. It's kind of sewed, you know, in like these different spots. So anyway, I'm working on that and having a lot of fun. So always exciting to get my sewing machine out, especially when it's like no pressure, you know, no pressure to make it look good, no pressure to make it like performance ready, like it's not going to fall apart on stage or something like that. So anyway, good way to spend the morning. Alright, so here it is, my new blanket and sheet attached. How awesome. Yeah, on the other side. You can see, maybe, that I sewed around and then I kind of just sewed some like little dots in the middle so that the like here, so that it's not like a big balloon, you know, it's sewed down. So, I am so excited! Ha. Cool! Look at that! No more itchy blanket, and perfect summer quilt when I'm ready. Anyway, thank you so much for watching today. I appreciate it. You can go ahead and check out pippinings.com if you're interested in joining some of the conversations about RV living and all sorts of topics that come along with that. You can also check out my blog.
and get your Keep It Simple bumper sticker. Thanks so much.